Right, my dear students, let's go ahead and start our class now. Baba, we'll be starting now with place of supply. Everyone, let me go ahead and give you a quick linking. Listen to me carefully. Where does the place of supply chapter lie? Everyone, over here. We started learning GST with goods or service. I hope you guys remember goods or service. Sir, goods or service has to be supplied. Then, sir, supply can be either interstate or intrastate. When I was teaching you inter or intra, I went ahead and told interstate supply means what? Sir, interstate supply, I went ahead and told you section number 7 went ahead and told inter means different state, different UT. Whenever location of supplier and place of supply are in different state, different UT, one state, one UT, then we go ahead and term it as what? Interstate. Whenever location of supplier and place of supplier in the same state, same UT, then Baba, we go ahead and call it as intrastate. That was told in section number 8. 9 told about territorial waters of India. Sir, supply is in the territorial water, deemed supply is in the nearest coastal state. Place of supply is in the territorial water, deemed place of supply is in the nearest coastal state. I hope you remember. Now we had section number 10, 11, 12, 13. If you remember, I went ahead and told you this is relating to determination of place of supply. Sir, why is place of supply required? Listen, we always see location of supplier and place of supply. We don't see location of recipient of service. We always see location of supplier of service or location of supplier of goods or location of recipient. We never see. We always see location of supplier and place of supply. Sir, if they are in the same state or if they are in the same UT, then we go ahead and tell it's an intrastate. Different state, different UT, then we go ahead and tell it interstate. Now, how to determine this place of supply? Everyone, listen to me very carefully. How to determine this place of supply? That is told by section number 10, 11, 12, 13. Are we clear, everyone? So here, let's go ahead and start understanding place of supply chapter. Baba, sir, it is very difficult. I feel this chapter is very big. Baba, very easy chapter. Trust me, after we are done with the chapter, you will feel just like every chapter, this chapter is also very, very easy. Are we clear, everyone? So let's go ahead and quickly start our understanding with place of supply. Everyone, over here. Place of supply. Sir, what do you mean by place of supply? Basically, the place where the supply is done. But in GST, you just can't go ahead and say that. Baba, in GST, place of supply is the destination place. And the destination, basically, place of supply will be that place which government will get the tax. Because if the place of supply is Karnataka, Karnataka government will get the tax. Are we clear, everyone? So, we'll have to go ahead and learn place of supply properly. Place of supply, don't apply your brain. As the law is telling, we'll go ahead and understand. We'll go ahead and listen to what the law is told. Now, law says place of supply is as per IGST Act. Okay, everyone? IGST Act, place of supply is section number 10. Whenever you are going ahead and determining place of supply with respect to goods or you are determining place of supply with respect to service, you will have to always remember place of supply with respect to goods, section number 10 of the IGST Act and section number 11 of the IGST Act is applicable. Place of supply relating to services when you are trying to determine section number 12 and section number 13 of the IGST Act is applicable. Now, section number 10 and 11. 11 says, sir, section number 11 says, whenever it's a case of import or it's a case of export, how will you determine place of supply? That is told by section number 11. Importation of goods or exportation of goods may, how to determine place of supply? That is told by section number 11. So, goods ka case may, if it is import ka case, if it is export ka case, which section will help you? Section number 11. But, sir, any other case, Baba, you will have to go to section number 10. That will only help you to determine the place of supply. Are we clear? Any other case other than import and export. Next, sir, services ka. Listen to me very carefully. Services mein what will happen? Section number 12 will tell when location of supplier and location of recipient both are in India. Both are in India, then how will you determine place of supply? That will be told by section number 12. Section number 13 will say when location of supplier or location of recipient, anyone is outside India, how to determine place of supply? Sir, see here, both have to be in India. Here, anyone is in India or anyone is outside India basically. So, sir, anyone is outside India, then how will you determine place of supply? That will be told by what? Section number 13. So, sir, we are going to start place of supply ka chapter. Baba, place of supply ka chapter mein, we will be learning place of supply with respect to goods. We will be learning place of supply with respect to services. Sir, place of supply with respect to goods, section number 10 of IGST Act, section number 11 of IGST Act. Services, section number 12 and section number 13 of IGST Act. Can I go ahead, everyone? Section number 10 goes ahead and say, 11 goes ahead and says, in case of import and export, how to determine place of supply? That will be told by section number 11. How to determine place of supply in case of other cases other than import and export of goods? That will be told by section number 10. Sir, services may section number 12 will be applicable whenever location of supplier, and location of recipient is in India. Both have to be in India. Sir, any one is outside India, then which section will be applicable? Section number 13. Can we go ahead, everyone? Yes, sir. People, you'll have to give me a thumbs up that yes, sir, we are done. Let's go ahead, everyone, now. Now, we'll go ahead and start with our section number 10 first. Everyone, in your chart, can you see section number 10? Section number 11, section number 12, and Baba, section number 13. Sir, why are we determining place of supply? First of all, understand the logic again. I am telling, whenever we see whether a supply is intra or inter, we see location of supplier and place of supply. Sir, location of supplier and we see place of supply. Location of supplier and place of supply, if they are in the same state, same UT, then we go ahead and say intrastate. If they are in different state, different UT, one state and one UT, then we go ahead and tell it is a interstate. Are we clear? Same state, same UT, intrastate, different state, different UT, inter. So, Baba, always location of supplier and location of recipient is not important to determine intra or inter. What is important? Place of supply. And place of supply determination is told by section number 10, 11, 12, 13. So, Baba, don't apply your brain. Apply section number 10, 11, 12, and 13 to determine place of supply. Right, everyone, can we go ahead? Chalo, let's go ahead and start with our section number 10 first. Section number 10 says, in case of goods, what is the section applicable? Section number 10. Section number 10 is applicable in case of goods, and section number 11 is applicable also in case of goods. Everyone, over here, section number 11 is also applicable in case of goods. So, section number 10 goes ahead and talks about goods. Section number 11 also goes ahead and talks about goods ka supply mein. What will be the place of supply? Let's go ahead and understand section number 11 first, then we'll move to section number 10. Section number 11 says, if goods are imported, Ramesh, listen, everyone, I'll be giving example. All these examples are written in your textbook. All these examples, Q&A material may are there. So just keep listening. Everyone, open your ear, eyes wide, and just keep listening and see on the board, right? You don't have to see here and there. You don't have to think about anything now. Everyone, over here now. Sir, I went ahead and imported some goods. When goods came from outside India into India, goods imported into India, in case of import, what will be the place of supply? Goods came from outside India into Mumbai. Okay? And I am a person, I am in Delhi. Are you able to understand? In this scenario, location of supplier is outside India. Yes or no? Location of supplier is outside India. Can you tell me what is the place of supply over here? What is the place of supply? Baba, we need just the place of supply now. Baba, place of supply will not be Mumbai. It will be Delhi. Sir, it is the location of the importer. Always remember, if you have imported some goods from outside India, what will be the place of supply? The place of the importer. The place of supply will not be Mumbai. The place of supply will be Delhi. Are we clear? Sir, I went ahead and got some goods from outside India into India. Now, I am in the state of supposedly UP. What is the place of supply? The location of the importer is the place of supply. Are we clear, everyone? Can we go ahead? Next. Sir, goods exported means you have taken the goods from India outside India. Sir, I have gone ahead and sent the goods from India to USA. Are we clear? What is the place of supply? Place of supply is USA, the place outside India. In case of import, the place is not the place in India. No. The place of the importer, where the importer is registered basically. In case of export, it is the location outside India. I hope everyone is clear. Location of the importer. Sir, tell me one thing. I went ahead and got some goods from outside India. I am in the state of UP. What is the place of supply? UP. Sir, I went ahead and sold some goods from India to UK. What is the place of supply? Place outside India, UK. Import and export, you understood? Other than import and export. Whenever it is goods ka case and it is not an import or export, where will you fall? Section number 10. Section number 10 goes ahead and says, Ramesh, whenever section number 10 has section number 10.1 and 10.2. सेक्शन नंबर 10(1) में देयर आर 5 केसेस. 10(2) गोज अहेड एंड सेज गवर्नमेंट हैज द पावर टू गो अहेड एंड सी व्हेन प्लेस ऑफ सप्लाई कैन नॉट बी डिटरमाइंड टू बी डिटरमाइंड इन द मैनर प्रेस्क्राइब गवर्नमेंट हैज द पावर टू गो अहेड एंड प्रेस्क्राइब द मैनर देयर इज नथिंग व्हिच हैज बीन प्रेस्क्राइब. सो सेक्शन नंबर 10(1)A सेज सर व्हेनेवर योर सप्लाई इन्वॉल्व्स मूवमेंट लिसन टू मी वेरी केयरफुली सप्लाई इन्वॉल्व्स मूवमेंट By supplier, recipient or any person. Listen to me very carefully. Supply involves movement, whether it is by the supplier, recipient or by any other person. What do you mean by supplier? I went ahead and supplied the goods. Everyone over here. Sir, for an example, I am in the state of Karnataka. Everyone over here. I am in the state of Karnataka. I went ahead and sold some goods to one person who is in Tamil Nadu. I told I will only put it in a truck. And I'll send it to you. Who is causing the movement? I am causing the movement. He told, sir, I will get my truck and I'll take the goods and go. Who is causing the movement? Tamil Nadu wala guy. Supposingly, this is the supplier, this is the recipient. There is one person who is basically the e-commerce operator went ahead and told, we will pick the goods from the supplier and deliver it to the recipient. Who is the person causing the movement? Mainly the intermediary, the person in between is causing the movement. Yes or no? So in this scenario, what is the place of supply? The place of supply is where the movement of the goods is terminating. If I am also sending, the goods are going here. He takes from here and goes, where are the goods going? Tamil Nadu. If any other person is going ahead and taking the goods, then also the place of supply will be Tamil Nadu. Why, sir? Because where the movement terminates for delivery to recipient. Can you tell me where am I delivering it to the recipient? Tamil Nadu. Where the movement terminates. The movement is terminating in Tamil Nadu. The place of supply will be Tamil Nadu. Are we clear, everyone? Can I go ahead? Now, the next one over here is, so it is supplier, recipient or any person. Movement can be caused by whom? Movement can be caused by supplier, recipient or any person. Can we go ahead, everyone? The next example, everyone over here, please, please, please keep seeing on the board. All the examples are there in your book. If you keep writing, you'll miss out on the examples which I'm talking. All are there in your book, Baba. Now listen, the next over here is, I am one person. I got an order for an example from Guru. Everyone knows Guru. Now this is Guru from Hyderabad. Guru from Hyderabad went ahead and told me, Ramesh, I want 100 television. He gave me an order for how much? 100 television. I did not have the television. I went ahead and gave the order to my supplier basically. There is a supplier. What the supplier did? No. He went ahead and gave me the invoice. I told this person, you will send me the goods. I will send the goods to him. Not required. Do one thing, sir. You just bill it to me. Bill to me. But do one thing. Ship. Put it in a truck and send it directly to this guy. Are we clear? If you see actually in this transaction, this is the supplier, this is the recipient. Yes or no? Correct? Who am I? I am a third party in the transaction. I am asking you which transaction? Which transaction I am talking? I am talking about this transaction. He went ahead and billed to me and he went ahead and shipped to this person. Billed to me and ship to this person. Can you tell me in this transaction what is the place of supply? He is from Karnataka. I am from Karnataka and he is in Hyderabad. Now what is the place of supply? Baba, if you see normally as per section number 10(1)A, you will say where the movement terminates. The movement is terminating in Hyderabad, correct? But no, they have specifically gone ahead and told whenever it's a bill to ship to moment. Bill to ship to ka case. Sir, principal place of business of third party. Can you tell me who is the third party? I am the third party. This will be the place of supply. Location of supplier is Karnataka. This is the place of supply. Can you tell me in his bill what will he charge? Sir, what will he charge? CGST and SGST. Can I go ahead? Sir, please tell once again. No, we want to listen. Listen to me very carefully. There is one person. Who is I have gone ahead and received one order from another person. He went ahead and told, Ramesh, I want 100 television. I am in the state of Tamil Nadu. There is one more supplier who is there. I went ahead and told the supplier, do one thing. You give me 100 TV ka invoice. And this supplier is from Karnataka. I am from Tamil Nadu. And this guy is in Hyderabad for an example. I went ahead and gave him the order. He gave me the invoice. So this is a bill to me. And sir, he went ahead and actually gave the goods to this guy. So sir, he shipped it to whom? This other guy. In this case, if you see, he is the actual supplier. He is the actual recipient. But then government went ahead and told in this scenario, because it's a bill to ship to model. In case of bill to ship to model, always remember Karnataka and Tamil Nadu. What will this guy go ahead and charge you? Sir, he will always go ahead and charge IGST. Why, sir? Because it is Karnataka and Tamil Nadu. Can I go ahead, everyone? I hope you got it. If it's a bill to ship to model, principal place of business, who am I? I am the third party. Why, sir, I am the third party? Because actually in this transaction, he is the supplier and he is the recipient. Can we go ahead, everyone? Can we go ahead, everyone? Next. Sir, let's go ahead. The third one. Supply does not involve movement. Everyone over here. I went ahead and gave Teja madam one machinery she is using in her factory. The machine is being used by Teja in her factory. Now what happened over here? I had given this machine to Teja to use. Now what happened? Teja madam went ahead and told me, sir, I like the machine. After 3 months, can you please sell it to me? As it is, where it is condition, may I sold it. Is the supply involving movement? When there is no movement, the place of supply will be the location of the goods at the time of delivery. Are you clear? I am in the state of Karnataka. I had given her the goods she was using in her factory. She was using it. After 3 months, she told, sir, please sell the goods to me. There is no movement. The goods are there only. I just sold it off to her. In that scenario, the place of supply will be location of goods at the time of delivery. Sir, location of the goods at the time of delivery. Can you tell me where is the location of the goods at the time of delivery? Tamil Nadu factory. So that is the place of supply. I'll give you one more example. Everyone over here. This is the building which is there. I am going ahead. I have my machinery over here. Okay, for an example, I have my machinery over here. Location of supplier, Karnataka. My machine is over here. I was vacating the building. When you are vacating the building, you went ahead and sold off the machine. Baba, where the machine was, there only you sold it off. Place of supply, Karnataka only. Place of supply will be Karnataka only. And you will go ahead and charge CGST and SGST. Baba, always remember, disposal in the course of furtherance of business is also supply, and GST will come. Sir, when I am closing my business, that is also business. Yes, Baba, go ahead, see the business card definition today in your supply chapter. At the time of closure of your business, if you are selling off the asset, that is also in the course of your business. Can I go ahead, everyone? You came to my shop, you took one mobile phone, I gave you the bill. Is there any movement which is happening for supplying? Is there any movement? There is no movement for supply. You came to my shop. I know you are here. I am here. Correct? Baba, place of supply is here only. But you told me, sir, I am going to take it to Tamil Nadu. Then the movement is terminating in Tamil Nadu. That will be the place of supply. You came to my shop. You never went ahead and told me where are you going to take it. I will feel you are from here. I am from here. The place of supply is here only. Are we clear? When there is no movement, always remember location of the goods at the time of delivery. But if you think movement is there, then where the movement is terminating, that is a place of supply. Can we go ahead, everyone? Next. Assembled or installed. Everyone listen to me very carefully. This is the state of Karnataka. This is the state of Tamil Nadu. Everyone over here. This is the state of Karnataka. This is the state of Tamil Nadu. Sir, I am going ahead. I am the supplier. Now what happened? You are the recipient. You told Ramesh, sir, can you go ahead and install one machine for me, for our factory? The recipient is from the place of Tamil Nadu. He told, sir, we want a machinery. Can you please go ahead and install one machinery for us in the state of Hyderabad? Baba, I am installing one machinery in Hyderabad. The place of supply will be Hyderabad only. Are you able to understand? Might be the supplier is in different state. Recipient is in different state. But where did you install the machine? In Hyderabad. Hyderabad will be the place of supply. Hyderabad is the place of supply where I went ahead and supplied the machine. Can I go ahead? For an example, I am in the state of Karnataka. Recipient is in Tamil Nadu. He told, sir, can you please install one machine in Karnataka for us? Recipient might have a factory in Karnataka. What is the place of supply? What is the place of supply? Where the machine is installed. This is the place of supply. Location of supplier is Karnataka. Machinery is installed in Karnataka. What will he charge? CGST and Karnataka SGST. This unit which is there, if it is registered, it will be able to take the ITC of CGST and Karnataka SGST. Can I go ahead? I am telling there is one person, he wanted a machine. I am the supplier in the state of Karnataka and there is a recipient, he is in the state of Delhi. Okay everyone, he told me, sir, can you please go ahead and install one machine in the state of Delhi. Now, when I am installing the machine in state of Delhi, the place of supply will be Delhi. What will I go ahead and charge? IGST. Now, this recipient who is there, since he is in Delhi, he will be able to take the ITC. He will be able to take the ITC of the IGST. Can I go ahead, everyone? So, always remember, in case goods are to be assembled or installed, the place of installation or assembly will be the place of supply. Can I go ahead, everyone? The next one is supplied on board. Everyone, listen to me very carefully. You went in a flight. In a flight, Baba, you are going, this flight is going from here. Then the flight went, this is Karnataka, Bangalore airport. Then from the Bangalore airport, the flight went to supposedly Hyderabad. And from the Hyderabad, the flight went to Assam. Everyone, Guwahati airport. Are we clear, everyone? Now, listen to me very carefully. The flight was flying in the sky. Are we clear? In the sky, supposedly, we have over here, Rahul, who is there. Baba, this is Rahul. Rahul told the air hostess, I want to buy a watch. Madam, in your magazine, it is given, you are selling a watch. Can you please sell a watch? Now, the watch was sold in the air. Might be this airline is registered in Karnataka. Location of supplier, Karnataka. But can you tell when the airlines is giving the watch, they will say, wait, let me see down, Baba, what is the place? Have we crossed Karnataka? If we have crossed Karnataka, then I'll charge you CGST, SGST or else IGST. Do you think that? No, Baba. What will be the place of supply? Because you can't see down and say, okay, this is the place of supply. What will be the place of supply here? Now, listen to me very carefully. These watches were loaded in the flight for selling from Hyderabad. The place of supply will be Hyderabad. See, place taken on board, where the goods are taken on board. Listen to me very carefully. This watch, when it is sold, what will be the place of supply? Where the watches was taken by the flight company on board to sell it. It was taken on board from where? Hyderabad. When it was loaded in the flight, they will think, okay, now if it is sold in Hyderabad only. From where the goods are taken on board. Can I go ahead? Now, supposedly, if Hyderabad, then what is the flight company going to pay GST? Location of supplier, Karnataka. Place of supply is Hyderabad, IGST. For an example, these goods were loaded in the flight from Karnataka only. What is the place of supply? Karnataka. Where the goods are taken on board. Can I go ahead, everyone? So, Baba, this is not only applicable in case of flights, etc. Applicable in case of train also. Applicable in case of bus also. Where the goods are supplied on board. Can I go ahead, everyone? I hope people are clear. When goods are supplied on board, place of supply will be the what? Place of supply will be what? The place where it is taken on board. Everyone, over here. I went ahead and started teaching you place of supply, section number 10, section number 11. Section number 11, I told, what is the place of supply? What is the place of supply, everyone? Sir, in case of imported goods and in case of export, basically, sir, import ka case mein, place of supply will be location of importer. Sir, export mein, location outside India. Section number 10 went ahead and told about where the goods involve movement. Then, Baba, where the movement terminates. Sir, if it's a bill to, ship to, please remember principal place of business of the third party, the center person. Supplier is he, recipient is he. I am getting the bill. I am the third party over here. Place of supply will be my principal place of business. Principal place of business. Sir, next one over here, where there is no movement. If there is no movement, the place where the goods are at the time of delivery, basically where you made it available. Sir, next, fourth one. Fourth one, installation or assembly. The place of such installation or assembly will be the place of supply. Sir, if goods are supplied on board means in a flight or might be in a train. Baba, in that scenario, the place of supply will be where the goods are taken on board. Where the goods are taken on board a plane or a flight or a train or a bus, wherever it is. Sir, where the goods are taken on board. Can I go ahead, everyone? Next. Sir, this was section number 10 and section number 11. Now, let's go ahead and read section number 12. Everyone, listen to me very carefully. Section number 12, may we have section number 12.1, which goes ahead and says, section number 12 will be applicable only when location of supplier and location of recipient both are in India. Section number 12 is applicable when location of supplier and location of recipient both are in India. Section number 12.2 goes ahead and tells general rule. Everyone, section number 12.2 goes ahead and says, generally, what is the place of supply? And then we have section number 12.3 onwards. If you guys can see over here, 3 to 14. Can you guys see section number 12.3 to section number 12, subsection 14? Everyone, listen to me very carefully. Section number 3 to section number 14, section number 12, subsection 3 to section number 12, subsection 14 are going ahead and covering specific cases. Means if you are falling in section number 3, 12, 3, 4, 5, 6, up to 14, then that subsection only will be applicable to you. But sir, if you are not falling in anywhere, then section number 12.2 will be applicable. General rule. So, sir, if I am falling in any specific rule will be applicable. If I am not falling in a specific rule, what will be applicable? General rule, which is section number 12, subsection 2. Next, everyone over here. Section number 12, which is there. What is section number 12 telling? Section number 12 goes ahead and says, in case of services, always remember, location of supplier and location of recipient, both are in India, only then section number 12 shall be applicable. Sir, when is section number 12 applicable? When location of supplier and location of recipient, both are in India. Can I go ahead, everyone? Sir, section number 12.2 talks about residual rule. It is a residuary rule. Residual rule. What do you mean by residual rule? Sir, if you are falling in 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, up to 14, if you are falling in any case, then you will not come under general rule. But if you are not falling in anyone, then Baba, you are a general rule. You will come over here. Then you will fall under, your case will fall under general rule. So, sir, if my case is falling in 3 to 14, then Baba, you will have to apply as per rule number 3 to 14, subsection 3 to 14. Sir, if I am not falling in 3 to 14, then Baba, you will apply general rule, which is section number 12.2. Section number 12.2 says, Ramesh, whenever you are supplying to a registered person, always location of the registered person is the place of supply. I went ahead and supplied to Teja. Teja is registered in Andhra. What is the place of supply? Andhra. Sir, I went ahead and supplied to Teja. Teja is unregistered. Then Baba, always remember, address on record. Do I have Teja's address? If I have Teja's address, that will be the place of supply. See, government is trying its best that the GST should go to the destination state. Are you guys able to understand? Think always, government is trying its best that GST should go to that state where the goods or services are basically consumed. Destination state. Can I go ahead? Place of supply ka rules are being drafted on the basis of the thought that destination principle is there. Can we go ahead, everyone? Yes, sir. Listen to me very carefully. Residuary rule. What is residuary rule telling? It says, sir, if you are going ahead and providing services to a registered person, location of the registered person. If I am going ahead and providing to anyone else, then, sir, if his address I have, unregistered person, address I have, address will be the place of supply because that is the destination. Sir, I don't have address also. You will have to say, sir, I am over here. You are over here. This is only the place of supply. If you don't have the address, location of supplier will be the place of supply. Are we clear, everyone? Can we go ahead? Always remember, first, location of the registered person. If that is not there, address on record. Address on record is not there. Sir, location of supplier will become the place of supply. Then, now, the services in relation to, so sir, we learned section number 12, subsection 1, which went ahead and told what? Sir, location of supplier and location of recipient, both are in India, then section number 12 shall be applicable. Sir, section number 12 two went ahead and told, look, if registered person who are supplying address, location of the registered person, if sir, I'm not supplying to a registered person, I'm supplying to unregistered person, address on record. Sir, address is not there. I am here, you are here, this is only the place of supply, location of supplier. Next, section number 12, subsection 3 is going ahead and telling, if you are going ahead and providing services in relation to an immovable property. Baba, I am going ahead and providing services in relation to an immovable property. For an example, interior designing services. Any services. One site is there in Tamil Nadu and I am doing site ka any work on the site. Site ko I am going ahead and repairing. Might be any work I am going ahead and doing relating to an immovable property. Might be I am getting a building constructed. Whatever it is, if it is in relation to immovable property, where the immovable property is there, that is only the place of supply. Sir, you went ahead and supplied services in relation to immovable property, directly in relation to immovable property, or lodging accommodation. You went to stay in a hotel in Kolkata, place of supply, Kolkata. Sir, function at an immovable property. Teja was getting married in Andhra. I went ahead and supplied the services. Relation to what? In relation to an immovable property. Baba, supposingly you are getting married in Andhra. The person whose property it was, he location of supplier is also Andhra. He will go ahead and tell you, madam, location of supply is Andhra. You are, for an example, I'll tell you. You went and got married in Andhra. You took a Kalyan Mandapam. Location of supplier, the owner of the Kalyan Mandapam, his location. Where is he registered? Andhra only. Location of recipient. Teja madam is from, supposingly, for an example, Karnataka. She would want that Karnataka mein she should get CGST, SGST ka credit, or at least she should charge IGST. But tell me one thing. You think your logic. You went to Andhra, used the resources of Andhra, got married in Andhra, all the kachra, everything done in Andhra, all the garbage thrown in Andhra. Now, don't you think Andhra government will need some money to clear all those things? So, Baba, the place of supply also will be Andhra. It says over here, where the immovable property is there, that is only the place of supply. You will have to think from that point of view, where the service was consumed. There, and you want IGST or credit over here. No, this guy will go ahead and charge you CGST and SGST, which is Andhra ka SGST. Now, if you are registered in Karnataka, you will not get the credit of it. Are we clear? But listen to me one carefully. Over here, if you see, this was a marriage function, personal things ka anyways you don't get. Even if it was an official function, you will not get the credit because the immovable property is in other state. Can I go ahead, everyone? Sir, whenever services in relation to an immovable property is provided, any service in relation to an immovable property, the place directly in relation, lodging, accommodation, function at an immovable property, might be in your function, any ancillary services were provided because the principal supply ka, because the principal supply ka place of supply is what? Andhra, where the immovable property is there, ancillary services ka place of supply also will be Andhra, where the, so sir, any ancillary services in relation to A, B, C, are we clear? Any ancillary service, because the principal supply ka location is Andhra, ancillary services ka location also will become Andhra. Can I go ahead, everyone? For an example, this guy went ahead and gave you immovable property ka services. He told, sir, I will also go ahead and organize music for you. I will also organize food for you. Because the principal supply ka place of supply is Andhra, all the ancillary services ka place of supply will also be Andhra. Can I go ahead, everyone? Next. So, it says over here, location or intended location of the property. Listen to me very carefully. I was hired to do the interior designing of a property which is going to come up in Delhi. It is not yet come up. When it comes up, then the place of supply will be what? Intended location is what? Delhi. The place of supply will be Delhi. I was asked to do a site preparation work. Big plot we took and I was asked to do a site preparation one. Small site I will make over there. I am making it in Tamil Nadu. What is the place of supply? Tamil Nadu. Location or intended location of property or boat or vessel. Always remember one thing. You know this Kerala houseboat is there. Baba, Kerala houseboat is not immovable. It is moving in the water. But still, they are telling boat is in Kerala. The place of supply will be Kerala only. That place of supply. Can I go ahead, everyone? Can I go ahead, boat or a vessel? Vessel means a ship. Are we clear, everyone? Next. Sir, If immovable property is located outside India, everyone listen to me very carefully. This is Shahrukh Khan. I am in India. Here, Shahrukh Khan is there in Maharashtra. Okay? And Shahrukh Khan told me in Karnataka, I am in Karnataka. He told Ramesh, you are a very good interior designer. Can you go ahead and do the interior designing of my home in Maharashtra, Mumbai, place of supply? Mumbai. He told Ramesh, I have a property in Dubai. Can you go ahead and do the interior designing of my property in Dubai? Place of supply. Mumbai. Why? Government is selling. If location of supplier is in India, place of supply also came in India. Correct? I will go ahead and charge what? IGST. Yes or no? If they would have gone ahead and told place of supply is outside India, it will become what? It can become export if Dubai say foreign currency comes in. Only then. Baba, government is selling. Government wants a tax on this because both the person are in India. If both are in India, government is selling. I want my GST. So government went ahead and told in this scenario, when you are in India, the person is also in India. What is the place of supply? Can you tell me over here? Mumbai, the location of the recipient. When immovable property is outside India, location of recipient. Can I go ahead? Shahrukh Khan went ahead and told me, Sir Ramesh, can you go ahead and do interior designing of my property? I told, okay, Shahrukh Khan. He went ahead and told, you have to do the interior designing of my property in Maharashtra, one which is in Delhi, one which is in Rajasthan. He went ahead and told me to do the interior designing of three properties. I am in Karnataka. I am going to do the interior designing of Maharashtra ka property, Rajasthan ka property, Delhi ka property. He gave me 2 lakh rupees. For an example, he gave me 2 lakh. What is the place of supply? Baba, for that 2 lakh, the place of supply is Maharashtra. For this 2 lakh, place of supply is Rajasthan. For this 2 lakh, the place of supply is Delhi. This is so easy. But sir, you know what happened? He went ahead and gave me 10 lakh. Now, what is the place of supply? You will have to see the contract. If in the contract it is written that you are going to go ahead and provide 1/3 service here, 1/3 of the service here, 1/3, then Baba, 10 lakh will be divided into 3 parts. And for 3,33,000, place of supply will be Maharashtra. For 3,33,000, Rajasthan. And for 3,33,000, Delhi. But sir, if this is also not possible, then what will you do? Then you will apply the rule. Then you will apply the rule. See over here, sir, immovable property is located in multiple state or UT. Immovable property is located in multiple state. Correct? Supply of service treated as made in each state or UT in the proportion to the value of services collected. Sir, in proportion to the value of services collected separately. Sir, if I have collected 2 lakh here, 2 lakh here, 2 lakh here, then place of supply will be in all the three location. In proportion to the value of services collected separately. For 2 lakh, the place of supply will be Maharashtra. For 2 lakh, the place of supply will be Rajasthan. For 2 lakh, the place of supply will be Delhi. Sir, or determined in terms of contract. Sir, if they have not gone ahead and given a separate amount, I have not collected separate amount for all the three place, but I have collected a consolidated amount, 12 lakh rupees, and they told 1/3, as per the contract it is, 1/3 services, okay, half of the services here, 1/4 of the services, 1/4 of the services, then can you tell me, for how much amount, what will be the place of supply? For 6 lakh, Delhi will be the place of supply. For 3 lakh, place of supply will be Rajasthan. For 3 lakh, the place of supply will be Maharashtra. I will go ahead and charge, when I am going ahead and supplying in Maharashtra, 3 lakh pay IGST. For this 3 lakh, I'll charge IGST, and for this 6 lakh, I'll charge IGST. And the respective tax will go to the respective states. IGST ka CG portion central government, SG portion to the respective states. I hope people are able to understand. The next one over here is, or as per rule number 4. Are we clear? Can I go ahead? Now, listen to me very carefully. Or rule number 4, in the proportion to number of nights or area or on the basis of declaration by the service provider. I'll tell you number of nights. Listen to me very carefully. Sir, what happened over here? For an example, I was given number of nights. I'll go ahead and explain. I gave ITC Hotel 30,000 rupees. How much I gave? 30,000 and they went ahead and charged me a consolidated amount and they are going ahead and allowing me to stay in Delhi for 2 nights and Agra for 1 night. Can you tell me what is the place of supply according to them now? The place of supply will be Delhi and the place of supply will be Agra also. But how much? 2:1. So for 30,000, 20,000 pay, they will go ahead and charge me GST and here Agra ke liye also they will go ahead and charge me on 10,000. So the place of supply relating to 20,000 is what? Delhi. And the place of supply relating to this 10,000 is Agra. Are you able to understand? The next one is or area. For an example, I was asked to go ahead and prepare one site. The site is located in Karnataka also and Tamil Nadu also. I was doing the site preparation work. Site preparation means cutting the site into small, small plots. For an example, I was doing for a site for one person in Karnataka. He had bought the site in Karnataka, but site ka some portion is in Tamil Nadu, border area. Here, 12,000 square feet is there. Here, 8,000 square feet is there. If in the contract he has specifically told that Ramesh, you will charge 12,000 rupees for Karnataka and 8,000 for Tamil Nadu, for 12,000 place of supply is Karnataka and for 8,000 place of supply is Tamil Nadu. But he went ahead and gave me 1 lakh rupees and he told Ramesh, this site ka site preparation work you will have to do. Now place of supply, because it's an immovable property, will be in Karnataka also and will be in Tamil Nadu also. But how much of that 1 lakh rupees will go to Karnataka? How much of the GST relating to 1 lakh will go to Karnataka government? How much of the GST relating to 1 lakh will go to Tamil Nadu government? Sir, 12:8, 3:2. So 60,000 rupees ke liye the GST will go to Karnataka government. For 60,000, the place of supply will be in Karnataka. For 40,000, the GST will go to the Tamil Nadu government. Are we clear? Can I go ahead? Next. This is Kerala, in the state of Kerala, and this is Karnataka. Okay, everyone, the houseboat which is there, this is the pond which is there. This is also in Karnataka only. Now, pond mein, here there is a houseboat. Okay, now who got married? Whoever got married. For an example, Nikhil got married and he thought, God's own country, I will go for my honeymoon in Kerala. Okay, he went, booked a houseboat. Okay, now what the houseboat went ahead and told, sir, we will go round whole day. Okay, and then we will stay mostly 20 hours in the state of Kerala. 4 hours we'll go ahead and stay in the state of Karnataka. This water may, we will go ahead and we'll be there for how many hours? 4 hours. Service provider has made the declaration. Now they went ahead and charged you, for an example, 48,000 per day. They fooled you. No, Baba, they charge you so much. Can I go ahead, everyone? Now, Baba, Kerala is a very good place. I love the place of Kerala and I love the people over there. Right, everyone? We all love Kerala. Can we go ahead? People watching from Kerala. Yes, sir. Now, everyone over here. Now, you tell me one thing. In this case, what will be the place of supply, everyone? The guy went ahead and charged you 48,000. How much GST will go to Kerala? How much GST should go to Karnataka? You will have to go ahead and do the apportionment on the number of hours. 20:4, 1:5. So for 48,000, how much? From which 40,000 pe GST will go to Kerala. And sir, 8,000 pe GST will go to Karnataka. Are we clear, everyone? All the three examples told by me over here now are there in your book. Please read it once again. Rule number 4 mein all the 3 examples are there. Baba, whatever I am talking is all there in your book. If you have not realized it till now, means you are not practicing question answers at home. Sir, we are not doing it. Baba, if you are not doing it, my condolences. Correct? Because you will not pass, you will call me only. So before only I am giving you condolences that you will not pass if you are not practicing question answers. Okay? Yes, sir. So Baba, start practicing question answers. Everyone over here now. Sir, why are you telling like this? Baba, if I'll not tell like this, no, then you will never go ahead and study. And it is very important to practice. Everyone over here. Next. Rule number 4 done. Now, sir, next. I went ahead and gave performance-based service. Performance-based services. What do you mean by performance-based service? Baba, I went ahead and did denting painting of a person. Beauty treatment I did. Okay, one person came from outside the state and he took a haircut in the state of Karnataka. What is the place of supply? Where the performance is done, your haircut done in Karnataka, you washed your hairs in Karnataka, water went off Karnataka, GST should come to Karnataka only, no. Can I go ahead and you are telling, I took a haircut in Karnataka, now I'm going back to Delhi. Baba, why will Delhi government get the tax? You came to Karnataka, all dirt made over here, water used over here, correct or not, place of supply should also be here only. Did you understand? Destination, which state ka efforts are involved? Can we go ahead everyone? Just think, which state will need that money more? That's all. Can I go ahead everyone? Baba, I love the state of Delhi also. It is not that I am against the state of Delhi. Everyone over here, performance based service, not any performance based service. It is only this performance based service, RCB, failed pathetically. Okay everyone, RCB failed pathetically. Sir, which services you are telling? Baba, nowadays RCB has started not only failing, Baba, they are winning also, correct? So let's go ahead and understand what is RCB failed pathetically. Baba, this is only for classroom purpose and classroom understanding. I love RCB. Now everyone over here, what I am telling is R for restaurant services or catering services, C for cosmetic and plastic surgery, B for beauty treatment, F for fitness services, P for personal grooming, and health services. All these services ke liye, what will be the place of supply? People, quickly write it. All these services ke liye, what will be the place of supply? Everyone over here, they are telling whenever it's a performance based service, which is RCB, failed pathetically, only for these six services they have told, sir, the place of performance. You came to Karnataka, you got a haircut done, beauty treatment provided in Karnataka, place of supply is Karnataka. Are we clear? I went to Jaipur, I called one person from Maharashtra. From Maharashtra, he came and gave me a haircut in Jaipur. The place of supply is where the performance is done. Health service. Baba, you came from Delhi to the state of Hyderabad to take some health services. Baba, that hospital or whatever it is providing the health service. The place of supply is where? Place of performance. Are we clear? You went for a denting painting, beauty treatment. You got a beauty treatment done in Karnataka, for an example. Place of supply is Karnataka. Are we clear, everyone? Can we go ahead? So always remember, POP is the place of supply in case of performance. Next. Training and performance appraisal service. Everyone listen to me very carefully. I was called by a company which is in Delhi. And Baba, when I was going to Delhi, no, in the airport they called me, sir, you don't have to come to Delhi, you have to go to Dehradun. So I was called by a company which is in Delhi, registered in Delhi, but I am going ahead and providing services in Dehradun. I am giving training and performance appraisal related service in Dehradun, but the company is registered in Delhi. So place of supply will be Delhi. Where am I going? I am from Karnataka. I gave the service in Delhi. Place of supply will be Delhi, not Dehradun. Sir, what if this company in Delhi is not registered? Then Baba, the place of supply will be Dehradun. Listen to me again. I am from Karnataka. I was going to Delhi. But this person in Delhi told me, he is registered in Delhi. He told, no sir, you don't have to provide us the service. You have to go to our Dehradun unit. In Dehradun, you have to go ahead and provide training and performance appraisal service. Whom did I go ahead and provide the service? To the Delhi unit, the place of supply will be Delhi. If the Delhi unit is unregistered, then the place of supply will be Dehradun. See, it is telling over here, whenever it is training and performance appraisal, registered person, location of the registered person. Unregistered person, then the place of performance. I went to Dehradun. For an example, one company is there. They are telling, sir, we want some training services from you. You please come. For an example, Tata Sky company, which is registered in Delhi. Tata Sky went ahead and told, sir, our sub-dealers who are there, no, they are in every state. We want you to go to Assam and provide our sub dealers को some training. But I will go ahead and raise the bill to whom? I will go ahead and raise the bill to whom? The company which is in Delhi. So Baba, place of supply will be Delhi. Registered person, then the place of the registered person, unregistered person. For an example, the Delhi company is unregistered. Where did I go ahead and do the performance? Where did I do the performance? Sir, Assam. So place of supply will be Assam. Next, everyone over here, admission to an event or park. Listen to me very carefully. Now, for an example, you went to Hyderabad. Hyderabad mein one park is there. Correct? You went to the water park, full dirty, you made the water, aram se you took a bath and you came back, enjoyed and came back. Now you tell me one thing, where should the money go? The money should go to the place where the park is there. Arjit Singh came to Bangalore, everyone from all the neighboring states came to Bangalore, right? Event held in Bangalore, security was given from Bangalore, all the grounds made dirty in Bangalore, correct or not? Bottles thrown here and there. Now, what is the place of supply? The place of supply is Bangalore, where the event is held. You have to think where the tax is required the most. Can I go ahead? So here, admission to an event and park or any services which are ancillary. In the park, you went ahead and had food, etc. But the place of supply will be that place only. Always remember, any ancillary services, event, Baba, event ka services were admission to an event. You went to an event. In if any other services are provided to you which are ancillary, principal supply was admission to an event. What do you mean by admission to an event? Entry. Entry ticket we are talking. We are talking admission to an event or park means the entry ticket. You came to Wonderla. We have Wonderla in Karnataka. Wonderla ke liye, what is the place of supply? Where the Wonderla park is. That is the place of supply. Place of event or park. Where the park is, that is the place of supply. Can I go ahead, everyone? Next. Organizing an event and any ancillary service. Or ancillary service, I'll not tell only because principal supply, what place of supply is that? That is only for the ancillary services. Now, ICI went ahead and told me, Ramesh, can you organize an event for us? For all our, this All India conference is happening. We are doing it in Delhi. Ramesh, can you organize the event? I am organizing the event. Not entry ticket now. I am organizing the event. For ICI, ICI is registered in Karnataka, place of supply, registered place, location of the registered person, because he would want to take the ITC. So government went ahead and told, so Baba, you can't apply much logic over here, correct? You will have to follow what is told in the law. I can't do anything about it, but place of supply ka law is made like that only. Can I go ahead, everyone? Now, organizing of an event. I organized an event for ICI Karnataka in supposedly Maharashtra, place of supply, because they would want the ITC. Government went ahead and told Ramesh, location of the registered person. Location of the registered person. Sir, ICI Bangalore is not registered. Then place of the event. Basically, where the event was held, that government will get the tax. Can I go ahead, everyone? Next. Sir, event outside India. ICI told Ramesh, I want the event to be held in Singapore. I am here, ICI is here. Place of supply, location of the recipient. ICI is in Karnataka, place of supply Karnataka. ICI is in Maharashtra, place of supply in Maharashtra. Can I go ahead, everyone? So it is telling over here, if event is outside India, location of the recipient. Can we go ahead? Sir, event held in multiple states. You know what happened? They went ahead and told me, ICI went ahead and told me, Ramesh, event held in multiple state. Everyone over here. I'll give you an example from the book only. 1 minute. Okay, everyone over here now. Listen. Sir, can you please go ahead and tell us if event is held in multiple state? Everyone over here. For an example, I was asked by a registered person, can you go ahead and provide us the services in two state? For an example, ICI. Went ahead and told, I am giving you the example, everyone, told me, ICI is a registered person and they went ahead and told me, Ramesh, can you go ahead and organize the event in Maharashtra and can you go ahead and organize the event in Rajasthan? We did the ICI ka event in two places, but always remember, whenever you are going ahead and providing the services to a registered person, sir, the place of supply is what? Location of the registered person, yes or no? But sir, supposingly, I went ahead and provided services to one person. He told, sir, I'm getting married. Can you organize the event in Delhi? What is the place of supply? Delhi. Are we clear? Now he went ahead and told me, for an example, who is getting married? Whom will we get married? Shubham. This is Shubham who is there. Shubham. And Shubham went ahead and told me, sir, I'm getting married. Now Delhi mein marriage should be there. Okay, marriage should happen in Delhi. And sir, in Kolkata, I want the engagement first. Okay, and then in Maharashtra, Mumbai, I want the reception. So I am going to organize three things for him. Yes or no? In this scenario, can you tell me, Baba, if I am providing this to a registered person, then I am providing to Shubham, who is a registered person, and all these are not unofficial kind of a thing. These are office ka work. For an example, it is a conference. Then Baba, registered person is the location of place of business, place of supply. I am going ahead and providing to Shubham. Shubham is in Delhi, and Baba, the conference is held in three locations. Then Baba, place of supply will be Delhi only. But here I am talking about Shubham, who is an unregistered person. If I am going ahead and providing to an unregistered person, and Shubham paid me, for an example, 30 lakh rupees. Everyone, Shubham paid me how much? 30 lakh rupees, Baba. So you can write one thing, whenever event is in multiple state, sir, if it is to registered person, then Baba, location of registered person always. If it is to unregistered person and you went ahead and charged a consolidated amount, and you are going ahead and charging a consolidated amount. For an example, I went ahead and charged 10 lakh for this place, 10 lakh for this place, 10 lakh for this event. Then what is the place of supply? Can you tell me? For 10 lakh, the place of supply is Delhi. For 10 lakh, the place of supply is Kolkata. For 10 lakh, the place of supply is Maharashtra. Sir, I went ahead and charged one amount, and as per the contract, I went ahead and charged 10 lakh from him, and I went ahead and charged 30 lakh from him, and as per the contract, it is one day event over here, one day event over here, one day event over here. I should charge 1/3 for every event. Then Baba, 10 lakh a place of supply is over here, 10 lakh a place of supply is over here, 10 lakh a place of supply is here. But sir, I went ahead and charged him 10. Okay. When I went ahead and charged him 10 lakh, 10 lakh and 10 lakh, in this scenario, I went ahead and charged him 30 lakh. Sorry. He is first of all an unregistered person. Secondly, I charged him a consolidated amount. Can you tell me what will be the place of supply in this scenario? In this scenario, you will have to apply generally accepted accounting principle. You went ahead and charged 30 lakh for an example. 30 lakh may say you are telling one day event is in Delhi. Okay, I charged him 40 lakh. And I told him 2 day ka marriage will happen in Delhi. 1 day ka engagement in Kolkata and 1 day ka reception in Maharashtra. Can you tell me place of supply? Sir, for 10 lakh, the place of supply will be here. For 10 lakh, the place of supply will be here. For 20 lakh, the place of supply will be here. Yes or no? So Baba, always remember, if you are providing services to a registered person, even in one location, multiple location, always it is the location of the registered person. Unregistered person, where the place of event is there. Are we clear? But sir, if unregistered person ko I am providing in three location for an example, and I am charging a consolidated amount, and I don't know how to go ahead and do the value apportionment, they are telling apply gap. How are you going ahead and doing the accounting? As per the generally accepted accounting principle, you have to go ahead and apply the gap. And basically over here I have gone ahead and told you what do they mean. They mean, sir, if you have charged 40 lakh rupees, 2 days ka event was held here, then 20 lakh will belong to this place, 10 lakh to this place, and 10 lakh to this place. So place of supply relating to 20 lakh is in Delhi, relating to 10 lakh is in Kolkata, and relating to another 10 lakh will be in Maharashtra. The same example is given in your book. If you go to page number 27.8, this is rule number 5, which you will have to read at home. Rule number 5, this is one example also, page number 27.8, you can read at home. I have explained you after reading. Can I go ahead, everyone? Shortcut me. Next. Sir, so you can write and keep event in multiple location to unregistered person plus consolidated amount is charged, then you will have to apply what? If in the contract it is written, very good. If in the contract it is not written, then you will have to apply gap. Next. Sir, transportation of goods including mail and courier. Everyone understand. I am a courier agency. Whenever a courier agency is going ahead and providing services to a registered person, location of the registered person. is the place of supply. If courier agency is going ahead and providing services to me, I am an unregistered person. I went to the courier office, gave them one goods. They will say where they picked up, that is only the place of supply. Always remember one thing, whenever you are going ahead and providing transportation, Baba, transportation of goods can be by road, rail, air, anything. Transportation ka services, listen to me very carefully. FedEx comes to my office to pick up. I am a registered person. According to FedEx, what is the place of supply? Location of the registered person. I am not a registered person. I am not a registered person. They come to my office, pick the goods and go. What is the place of supply? Where they pick up. Where the goods are handed over, basically they pick up. I went to their shop and gave the goods. If I give them my GSTN number, as per my GSTN number, they will determine the place of supply. If I don't give them the GSTN number, Baba, where I give them the goods, that is only the place of supply. I went to Delhi to buy some goods. I bought it in Delhi only. I am from Karnataka. I bought the goods in Delhi. Now I gave it for transportation to Karnataka. That guy is going to transport the goods. If I give him the GSTN number, place of supply will be Karnataka. If I don't give him the GSTN number, where I give him the goods, that is only the place of supply. All the examples done. Here one proviso is there. Listen to me very carefully. I am in India and goods are being transported from India outside India. What is the place of supply? Baba, generally, if supplier and recipient both are in India. See, 12 is applicable when supplier and recipient both are in India. Listen to me very carefully. I am in India. Okay, location of supplier, India. Now, there is a foreign Indian shipping company. Okay, Indian shipping company is located in India. Location of supplier, India. I who wanted the goods to be sent to US. I have an order from the US. I wanted the goods to be sent to US. Who is getting the services? I am only getting the services. Suppliers in India, recipient is in India. Which section will be applicable? 12. But goods are being transported outside India. No, here the place of supply will be what? The place of supply will be outside India. Are we clear, everyone? Can I go ahead? Now, if you say location of supplier is in India, location of recipient is also in India, even if the place of supply is outside India, can it become export of service? It will not become export of service. The supplier is in India, recipient is outside India, only then it becomes export of service. Are we clear? Can I go ahead? So, government is telling here the place of supply is outside India. That's all. You just have to know the place of supply. The place of supply is outside India. Everyone over here. Transportation outside India, the place of supply will be destination of the goods. Destination of the goods is outside India. Next. Sir, passenger transportation service. Listen to me very carefully. You know Indigo Airlines. Airline company is in passenger transportation service. Baba, passenger transportation need not be only flight. I have drawn flight. But passenger transportation can happen by road, rail, air, anything. Sir, what is the place of supply? If I am a registered person, I will want the ITC. Indigo, when it is providing to the registered person, the place of supply will be the location of the registered person. Are we clear? Transportation services, may always remember, registered person, location of the registered person. If I am an unregistered person, Indigo is located in Karnataka. I am jumping into the flight from Mumbai. Place of supply, where I jump in. It says place of embarkation if it is unregistered person for a continuous journey. Continuous journey means when there is no break. Means you don't have to embark from the, get down from the flight and get into another flight. If you are getting down from the flight and getting into another flight, then it is two separate journeys. Can we go ahead, everyone? Sir, if it is two separate journeys, two separate place of supply will come. But I am talking about continuous journey. Sir, Indigo gave me services. I am registered in Karnataka. What is the place of supply? Karnataka. I got into the flight from Mumbai, Delhi, whatever it is. Place of supply is Karnataka only because I am registered in Karnataka. If I am not registered and Indigo gave me a service, where I jump in the flight, that is only the place of supply. Can I go ahead? Indigo issued me a right to passage. They gave me a ticket and told, sir, you can get into our flight from wherever you want. You can get into the flight from wherever you want. You know Metro card? Metro card is a right to passage. Or Indigo gave me a card and told, sir, you can get into our flight from wherever you want. What is the place of supply? Metro card, you can get into the metro from anywhere you want, right? That's a right to passage. Indigo Airlines gave me a right to passage and told, sir, you can get into our flight from wherever you want. What is the place of supply? Sir, place of supply as per general rule. If it's to registered person, place of the registered person. His address is there, then address on record. If address is not there, location of the supplier is the place of supply. Can I go ahead, everyone? Always remember, supposingly, I booked a going trip and coming back a trip. Both are separate journeys. For both the journeys, you'll have to determine place of supply separately. Can I go ahead, everyone? Next. Sir, onboard services. You are going in Indigo. Everyone over here. Indigo Airline is there. Indigo Airlines went from Karnataka. Location of supplier registered in Karnataka. Went from Karnataka to Hyderabad. From Hyderabad, it went to supposedly Guwahati, Assam. Guwahati, Assam. Now, in this scenario, in the flight, supposedly food was provided to you. Now, when the airline company is selling you the food, they will see down, oh, sir, we have already crossed Karnataka. Will it do that? No, Baba, in that scenario, location of supplier is Karnataka. What is the place of supply? Baba, see, first scheduled departure point, not where the food got in. The first scheduled departure point was Karnataka. In case of goods, where the goods are taken on board. In case of services, the first scheduled departure point. First scheduled departure point will be the place of supply. Can you tell me what is the place of supply? Karnataka. Can you tell me what will they charge you? CGST and SGST. Can I go ahead, everyone? Next. Sir, telecommunication services. Everyone, can you tell me what did we learn till now? We went ahead and learned place of supply. Place of supply may I went ahead and taught you section number 10. I taught you section number 11. Section number 10, in case of import and export. Here, place of importer. Sir, here, place outside India. Sir, section number 10, 1A was there. A, B, C, D, and E. A point told when supply involves movement. Where the movement terminates. Bill to, ship to. Then, of the third party. C was what? Sir, supply does not involve movement where the goods are delivered or basically made available. Can I go ahead? Sir, if it is installed or assembly ka case, where the goods are installed or assembled. This is goods on board, where they are taken on board. Taken on board. Can I go ahead, everyone? Sir, now we'll learn section number 12. Section number 12, I went ahead and told you. Section number 12, one went ahead and told, whenever location of supplier and place of supply both are in the same state, same country, Baba, both are in India basically, then Baba will use section number 12. Section number 12, 2 went ahead and told general rule. General rule, location of registered person, if that is not there, address on record, if that is also not there, then location of supplier. Third one went ahead and told about immovable property related services, location of the immovable property or the boat. Can I go ahead, everyone? Fourth one went ahead and told performance based services, RCB, failed pathetically. Baba, performance, place of performance is the place of supply. Correct? Sir, fifth one told about event, the place of the event or the place of the event. What is it? Okay, fifth one is training and performance appraisal. Okay, Baba, fifth one is training and performance appraisal. If I am giving these services to a registered person, location of the registered person, unregistered person, place of performance, same. Sir, sixth one, event related services. If I am going ahead and providing, then place of event. Sir, seventh one, transportation of. Ah, Baba, you will have to tell, no. People, you will have to talk with me. What is it? Now, in front of you, in the book, it is written organization. If I am telling transportation, then you will think the book is wrong. Then, it is organization of event. Baba, after event, this is admission of the event. The next one will come, organization of event. Registered person. Place of the registered person. Basically, location of the registered person. Unregistered person. Place of event, sir, event is in multiple location and one single amount is charged from the unregistered person. Sir, in that scenario, you will have to apply gap rate. Can I go ahead? Number 8. Transportation of goods, sir, registered person, location of the registered person, unregistered person, pick up. Can I go ahead, everyone? The 9th one, can you tell me the 9th one? Passenger transportation services, can you tell me passenger transportation service? Sir, registered person, location of the registered person, unregistered person, jump, where you embark. Next, sir, it is goods supplied on board, correct? Goods on board, when you are in a flight, train, bus, etc. and you are supplied some goods, then Baba, section number 10 was applicable. What is applicable over here? Baba, this is services, not goods. Tell no. Whatever sir is telling, everything. You'll have to tell no, it's a service. I'm talking about service. Service on board. It will be first scheduled departure point. There it was. Pick up. Picked up. Next, everyone over here. Telecommunication service. Listen to me very carefully. Sir, if services are provided by fixed line, circuit, dish TV, etc. Baba, wherever that circuit is installed, wherever that fixed line is installed, wherever that landline is installed, that is only the place of supply. Can I go ahead? BSNL installed one circuit in my office for internet. What is the place of supply? Office only. This is the location of the registered person where the basically the circuit is installed. I got a circuit installed at my home. That is the place of supply. Can I go ahead, everyone? Sir, I went ahead and got one dish TV installed at my home in Assam. What is the place of supply? Assam. When one person is going ahead and billing, he will go ahead and see the place of supply. The place of supply is where the fixed line is there or the circuit is there or the dish TV has been installed. Next, postpaid mobile. Baba, BSNL say I took one postpaid mobile. Listen to me very carefully. This is Assam. In Assam, BSNL is there. I went to BSNL and I took one postpaid connection. In the postpaid connection, the BSNL is from Assam. Location of supplier? Assam. Sir, in the postpaid, I have given Karnataka ka address. My driving license was from Karnataka. What is the place of supply? Karnataka, because the billing address is Karnataka. Can I go ahead, everyone? They will not see location of recipient. They will see the place of supply. And place of supply is what is the billing address. Next. Sir, prepaid mobile phone. Everyone understand very carefully. This is Reliance. Reliance will first go ahead and sell the mobile ka prepaid voucher. Vouchers will be sold. No, earlier it used to come scratch card. Vouchers will be sold to distributor. This is a reseller. Yes or no? He will go ahead and sell it to the final consumer. Correct? So, whenever prepaid vouchers are sold, there are two things which are happening. Number one, company sells it to a reseller. Reseller goes ahead and sells it to final consumer. Do you think Reliance sells you directly? As of now, you think Reliance is selling to a reseller. What will be the place of supply over here? And what will be the place of supply over here? It is telling through selling agent, reseller or distributor, then address of the selling agent. Place of supply is selling agent. Can I go ahead? Sir, by any person to final subscriber, might be they went ahead and sold it directly or through a selling agent they are selling. In both the scenario, can you tell me what will be the place of supply? It is selling where prepayment is received. Baba, example, this voucher was sold in Assam. What is the place of supply? Assam. Can I go ahead, everyone? So, sir, when company is selling to a reseller, the place of supply will be where the reseller is there. If reseller is in Assam, place of supply will be Assam. Reseller went ahead and sold it to final consumer or company is directly selling to final consumer. Where the prepayment is received, wherever the prepayment is received, that is the place of supply. If money is received basically in Assam, the place of supply will be Assam. Next, sir, prepaid services through internet banking. Baba, you went online and you took one prepaid service. Prepaid ka amount you went ahead and paid over the internet. If Reliance has your address, address on record is the place of supply. If Reliance has your address, Baba, Reliance went ahead and sold you a prepaid SIM, prepaid voucher on the internet. Nowadays, internet is happening. If Reliance has your address, address on record shall be taken. Sir, if they don't have my address, location of supplier is the place of supply always. Can I go ahead, everyone? The next one over here is other cases. Sir, any other case? Reliance went ahead and sold me a voucher. Any other case they are talking? Any other case? Address on record is not there, then take location of supplier. Did I tell you? Can I go ahead, everyone? Next. Sir, one explanation is there. For an example, listen. You know this BSNL etc. will do what? I am in the state of Assam. Assam mein I took BSNL ka one leased line. They will install one circuit and they will install one leased line. I can access the internet. BSNL gave me the internet. Place of supply? Assam. Sir, this leased line is connected from my Assam office. This leased line came and it is connected in my Kolkata office also, West Bengal. Okay, and from the West Bengal, it is also connected to my Delhi office. Baba, for high speed internet, what we took, we took a leased line which was connected from here to Kolkata and Kolkata to Delhi. And BSNL is going ahead and charging me might be 30,000 rupees for the leased line connection. Can you tell me the place of supply? Place of supply will be Assam also, Kolkata also, and Delhi also. Sir, what will be the ratio of the value? If value is given separately, they are charging separately, then separate value. If they are not going ahead and charging you separately, then 1:1:1. Common sense? Yes. So it says leased line is greater than one state or UT in proportion to the value or in terms of the contract. If that is also not there, apply rule number 6, which says in proportion to number of points lying in the state or UT. For an example, this leased line ka one more point is lying in West Bengal only. West Bengal mein I have 2 circuits which are installed. Can you tell me now what will be the ratio? 1:2:1. So this 30,000 value will be distributed between all the 3 states and 7,000 or 7,300, whatever, 7,500. Okay, 7,500, 15,000 and 7,500. Are we clear? For 7,500, the place of supply will be this place. For 15,000, West Bengal. And for 7,000, Assam. Are we clear, everyone? That is what is being told over here. Last over here, it talks about financial and stock broking services. But we know this, all these stock broking services are given by all these brokers, etc. What will be the place of supply? It says address on record. Baba, if Motilal Oswal, you know Motilal Oswal, Sher Khan, etc., they give you what? Financial and stock broking services. If they have your address, that is the place of supply. If they don't have your address, the location of supplier of service. I opened an account with Zerodha online. They are into stock broking services. I went to online, Zerodha, I opened an account. They are into stock broking services. They went ahead and gave me the services. If they have my address, place of supply is my address. If they don't have my address, location of the supplier of service. Next, insurance services. I went ahead and took Tata, say, insurance. Baba, they are talking about insurance services. I went to Tata and Tata went ahead and gave me insurance ka services. I am registered person. Location of the registered person. If I am not registered, whatever address they have, that is the place of supply. Are we clear? Baba, for insurance providing, they will take your address. So, the address will be the place of supply. If they don't have the address, Baba, whatever is the location of the registered person. First of all, registered person, location of the registered person. Sir, if location of the registered person is not there, take address on record. Can I go ahead, everyone? Next. Sir, the last one over here is advertisement services to central government, state government, local authority or statutory body. What happened over here? Advertisement services, I am going ahead and providing to central government, state government, local authority or statutory body. Baba, if I am providing general advertisement services, then apply residuary rule. But sir, if I am providing advertisement services to whom? Central government, state government, local authority or any statutory body meant for states or UT. What happened? Central government went ahead and told Ramesh, please go ahead and do the advertisement saying, please give up your subsidy. Baba, government is advertising, no, give up your subsidy. So I am the company who is going ahead and doing this advertisement for the government. Are we clear? What is the place of supply? It says over here, place of supply in every state or UT and value proportion to amount attributable to service provided in each of the respective state in terms of contract or as per rule number 3. Government went ahead and told me in the contract, listen to me very carefully. Government went ahead and told Ramesh, we will pay you 9 lakh rupees. This is the central government and I am the advertisement company. I am giving advertisement services to whom? Government. Government told Ramesh, you have to do advertisement in Delhi, you have to do in Maharashtra and you have to do in Karnataka. Basically, the advertisement Ramesh you have to do is please give up your subsidy. So I am doing the advertisement for the government. So basically, I am providing the services to the government. Location of suppliers, for an example, Delhi. What is the place of supply? I am going ahead and doing advertisement in Delhi, Maharashtra and Karnataka. Place of supply will be the respective state. Government is giving me 9 lakh and government told in all the 3 states provide the services equally. Can you tell me what will be the value of services in 3 lakh, 3 lakh, 3 lakh? Are we clear? Now government had gone ahead and told me if this is not there, then what will you do? If government in the contract it is not written, then on what proportion will you go ahead and do the value apportionment? Sir, then you will have to see. Then you will have to see if manner for determining of value attributable, you will have to apply which rule? Rule number 3. And rule number 3 says, Ramesh, listen. Government told you to do the advertisement in newspaper, for an example. What? Newspaper. I am doing the advertisement for the government in newspaper. Now, in Delhi, to advertise in the newspaper, I spend 1 lakh rupees. In Maharashtra, to advertise in the newspaper, I have spent only 50,000. To advertise in Karnataka, I paid to the newspaper agency 50,000. Can you tell me 9 lakh to be divided in what ratio? Whatever I am spending in each state, amount payable by me, advertisement company in each of the state is how much? 2:1:1. So this 9 lakh will be distributed, or I'll go ahead and say, supposing this is 10 lakh rupees paid by the government to me, 5 lakh, 2.5 lakh and 2.5 lakh for this GST will go to Delhi, for this GST will go to Maharashtra, for this GST will go to Karnataka. Did you understand? Listen to me very carefully. Sir, government went ahead and told me, please Ramesh, go ahead and do advertisement for me. I am an advertisement company. And government went ahead and told me, Ramesh, you will have to do advertisement for me over the internet that educate the girl child. Government told me to give advertisement so that people know that government is telling educate the girl child. For an example, Beti Padhao. Government went ahead and told, Baba, the advertisement comes like that only. Beti Padhao. Government is telling to educate the girl child. Now, government went ahead and told me, do the advertisement in 3 states, Ramesh. For an example, Delhi, UP and Baba Bihar. For an example only, everyone. Now, government went ahead and told me, please do the advertisement in all the 3 states. I want all the 3 states. May you do advertisement over what? Internet. And government went ahead and gave me 12 lakh rupees. Are we clear? If government had told me to do the advertisement equally, then 4 lakh, 4 lakh, 4 lakh. But if nothing is told in the contract, how will you go ahead and do the value apportionment? You will have to see internet subscribers. Here, internet subscribers are 1 lakh. Here, internet subscribers are 2 lakh. Here, internet subscribers are 4 lakh. What will be the ratio of distribution of this 12 lakh? 1:2:4. How much? Sir, this is... Okay, sir, you make it little easy. No, make it 7 lakh. Then, 1 lakh rupees will come here. 2 lakh rupees will come here and 4 lakh rupees will come here. Listen, this is the internet subscribers. So on which ratio did I divide? On the basis of internet subscribers in the state. Are we clear? For this amount, the GST should go to Delhi. For an example, I am in Delhi only. Location of supplier Delhi, place of supply Delhi. I should charge CGST and SGST. Baba, for this amount, I should charge IGST. For this amount, I should go ahead and charge IGST. Did you guys get it? That's all I'm going ahead and telling. See, if you are going ahead and doing newspaper in newspaper and publication, how much you are spending, that will be the ratio. Who? The advertisement company is spending, no? That amount. Sir, printed material, how much is the amount payable for printed material in every state? Sir, if it is done in hoarding, Baba, big hoardings will be there. I am doing the advertisement for the government in hoarding. How much I am spending for hoardings in every state? That ratio may the value shall be apportioned. Sir, train may advertisement. Railway track ka length I'll have to see in every state. Next, sir, utility bill. Behind the utility bill, gas bill, you'll see no advertisement for the government. Give up your subsidy. That company is doing it. So if government gave 10 lakh, on what ratio the company will distribute that? On the amount payable to Indian. For an example, Karnataka, they paid, advertisement company paid to Indian. In Tamil Nadu, they paid to Bharat Gas. How much is the amount spent by them? On that ratio, they will go ahead and up distribute their income. Next, not income, basically the amount which they have received from the government. Railway ticket, number of railway station. Sir, railway radio station, may I did advertisement for the government, then amount which we have spent. Sir, television may advertisement on the basis of viewership. Sir, cinema hall may advertisement on the basis of amount payable to every cinema hall. Are we clear? Government went ahead and told me, Ramesh, government, central government told me, Ramesh, do an advertisement relating to tobacco. You will see, no, in every cinema hall that tobacco wala advertisement will come. Yes, sir. So government told, supposingly, one advertisement company that please do the advertisement in the state of Karnataka, in the state of Delhi, and in the state of Assam. Every cinema hall may this advertisement should be done relating to that tobacco. Please don't chew tobacco. And I was given 12 lakh by the government. Are we clear? Based on the number of cinema hall. Here, supposingly in 100 cinema hall, the advertisement is shown by me. Here in 50 and here in 50. What ratio may will I go ahead and divide this 12 lakh? 2:1. On that ratio, I'll divide this 12 lakh and accordingly, 6 lakh, 3 lakh, 3 lakh. For 6 lakh, GST will go to Karnataka. For 3 lakh, GST will go to Delhi. And for 3 lakh, GST will go to Assam. Baba, all these examples are there in your book. Next, sir, internet subscriber, advertisement over SMS, telecom subscribers. I hope you guys got it and you had a beautiful understanding. Everyone, now before I go ahead and close, I want to go ahead and quickly revise section number 10, 11, 12. Now, sir, section number 10, can you go ahead and tell me section number 10, everyone? Sir, place of supply, you went ahead and told section number 11. Section number 11 had A, 11 had B, and section number 10. 11A told import ka case mein, everyone, you are not seeing the book. Place of importation. Export ka case mein. Location outside India. Sir, section number 10, A, B, C, D, E. Sir, if movement is there, where the movement terminates. Sir, build to ship to. Third party ka principal place of business. Sir, movement is not there. Where goods are made available or basically delivery is happening. Installation or assembly. Place of installation or assembly. Sir, goods taken on board. Place which is taken on board. Can I go ahead? Sir, then we had section number 12. Sir, section number 12A. 1. Location of supplier and place of supply both are in India. Then place you will use section number 12. Section number 12.2 went ahead and told general rule. Location of registered person. If registered person ka location is not there, take address on record. That is not there, take location of supplier. 12.3 went ahead and told immovable property. Location of the immovable property. Sir, location of supplier and location of recipient both is in India. Immovable property is outside India. Then you will have to take location of the recipient. Next, sir, fourth one over here. Fourth one, performance-based services. Performance-based services, RCB failed pathetically, place of performance. Fifth one told about, fifth one, training and performance appraisal. Sir, registered person, location of registered person, unregistered person. Unregistered person, sir, place of performance. Sir, sixth one told about, admission to an event, place of event. Can I go ahead, everyone? Next, seventh one went ahead and told about organizing of events. Sir, organizing may registered person, location of registered person, unregistered person, place of the event basically. Are we clear? And always remember, if the event is held in multiple location, correct, then place of supply will be in multiple location, gap rate. Sir, eighth one told transportation of goods may location of registered person, if unregistered person, then where they are picked up. Can I go ahead, everyone? The ninth one over here. Passenger transportation services. Sir, registered person, location of registered person, unregistered person, place of embarkation, basically jump in. Can I go ahead, everyone? Everyone, please concentrate over here. The next one. Sir, the onboard services which are there, sir, basically first scheduled departure point has to be taken. Then we had telecommunication services, yes or no? If it is provided to fixed line, location of the fixed line circuit, etc. Sir, postpaid, billing address, prepaid. Prepaid, you will have to go ahead and see. If it is provided through reseller, then location of the reseller, basically, place. Sir, if it is provided directly or through the reseller, basically, where the prepayment is received. Otherwise, it is always address on record. Are we clear? If address on record is not there, take location of supplier. If lease circuit is there in more than one state, take on the basis of basically how much circuits are installed in how many state. Sir, after the telecommunication service, what was the next one? Sir, financial and stock broking services may, it will always be the address on record. Can I go ahead? If that is not there, location of supplier of services. Sir, next, here it is, insurance services provided to registered person, location of registered person. If it is provided to unregistered, address on record. Sir, then it is advertisement services to government. Government, if you are providing advertisement services, you will have to apply rule number 3. I have already gone ahead and told you. I hope people are clear. First of all, you will have to see the contract. If you can't determine as per the contract, rule number 3 went ahead and told. Newspaper and magazine, if you remember, newspaper and magazine may amount payable, printed material amount payable, sir, hoardings may amount payable. Sir, train ke liye railway track, otherwise utility bill, amount payable. So, all this please read and go, don't leave it. Can I go ahead, everyone? We are done with section number 12. Right, everyone. After the break, we'll go ahead and do section number 13, everyone.